Hello and welcome to Newsclick. I'm Anusha Paul and this is another episode of Newsclick's Daily Roundup. Every year ahead of the Hindu festival of colors, Holi, detergent companies advertise their products, jumping on the obvious opportunities. This year as well, a detergent brand, Surf Excel, came up with an advertisement ahead of the festival, purportedly conveying the message of Hindu-Muslim harmony. However, the brand has ended up receiving flak from online trolls and Hindutva bodies. Soon after the ad was shared on Hindustan Unilever's Twitter handle, many users objected to it as they claimed that it hurt sentiments of the Hindus and portrayed the festivals in a bad light. In case you are wondering what exactly wrong with the ad, let me explain briefly about this 1 minute ad with the theme Rang Laye Sang. The ad features two kids, a young Hindu girl and a Muslim boy. The girl dressed with a white rides on a bicycle and challenges the neighborhood kids to splash her with holy colors. It is later revealed that it was in order to exhaust the colors and the balloons available, so as to protect her Muslim friend who had to go to a nearby mosque for prayers. Many users objected to it as they claimed that it hurt sentiments of the Hindus and portrayed the festival in a bad light. While Unilever, which on Surf Excel attempted to promote religious harmony with the advertisement, not many appreciated the sentiment. Many said it was Hindu-phobic, promoting love jihad, and some even said that it wants to make a statement that the Muslim prayers namaz is more important than Hindu festival Holi. The ad was also criticized by some Muslims who reportedly didn't like the premise where a Muslim boy needed the help of a Hindu girl to go ahead with his prayer. The Twitter was filled with tweets slamming the ad with the hashtag #BoycottSurfExcel. While Hindustan Unilever, which on Surf Excel attempted to promote religious harmony with the advertisement, not many people appreciated the sentiment. Many said it was Hindu-phobic, promoting love jihad, and some even said that it wants to make a statement that the Muslim prayers namaz is more important than Hindu festival Holi. The campaign then moved to the Play Store where the people decided to download the official Android app of Surf Excel in an amusing turn of events. However, many users mistook the Microsoft Excel app as the Surf Excel Excel app or something owned by the Surf Excel. If you check out the Microsoft Excel app on the Play Store, the scroll through the review section, you will see some reviews that incorrectly bash the Microsoft for coming up with the said app. Recently, Hindustan Unilever was criticized by netizens for a Brewpoint tea ad that was featured elderly citizens abandoned at the Hindu religious gathering Kumbh Mela. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's monthly radio broadcast Mann Ki Baat has turned out to be a flop show in the past 5 years, reveals the pan-India data provided under the Right to Information Act 2005. In response to RTI queries filed by Delhi-based activist Yusuf Naki, who has sought the listenership data of the Prime Minister's monthly address to the nation, AIR said the average of All India average listenership of the program in Hindi and regional languages in rural as well as the urban India has continuously witnessed a decline. The public radio service provider did not give any absolute number, yet the figures in percentage shows the program miserably failed in drawing the audience in the several places such as Ahmedabad in Gujarat, Nagpur in Maharashtra, Jaipur in Rajasthan, Rohtak in Haryana, Shimla in Himachal Pradesh, Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh, and Jammu and Kashmir. And an analysis of month-wise average data of listenership shows the Prime Minister's much puffed-up radio broadcast could draw only 20-30% of radio FM audience across the country. In fact, the numbers could not even touch two digits in several places in the country. Prime Minister Modi, on 25th of February, suspended his monthly broadcast for March and April, saying that he would be back with the program on the last Sunday of May, by when the results of the Lok Sabha elections would be declared. Having officially stated from the October 3, 2014, Mann Ki Baat aimed to deliver the Prime Minister's voice to the general masses of India. He talked about wide range of topics such as cashless India, digital payments, goods and service taxes, exams, toilets, among others during the broadcast. Since television connection is still not available anywhere in India, especially in the isolated rural and less developed regions, radio was chosen to be the medium for the program, owing to its wider spread. and an estimated 90% of India's population is reachable over the medium as on 2017, AIR is said to be one of the largest radio network with 422 stations across the country. Additionally, various private FM radio stations in the metropolitan cities of India were allowed to broadcast a recording of the show. The usual ad slots on AIR sold on ₹500 to ₹1,500 per 10 seconds, but a 10-second ad slot for the PM's radio address costs ₹2 lakhs. As we talked yesterday about the most critical and the controversial move of PM Modi, the demonetization, we continue the discussion today with our editor-in-chief Prabir Purkayastha and senior journalist Paranjoy Thakurta shed more some lights on the new revelations in the controversy.
Paranjoy, you have been covering this issue as well as Newsclick has been, shall we say, from the beginning, deeply interested on the sequence of events. Latest RTI, Paranjoy, the response by the Reserve Bank to the RTI requesting the sequence of events that led to this decision was given last week and has appeared in the press recently. What are the key issues that the RTI answer reveals? That was the board really, did it really apply its mind? Was it a decision of the Reserve Bank of India or was it a fait accompli given by the government?
Prabir, what has been revealed by the Reserve Bank of India after a gap of 2 years and 4 months?
28 months.
Thanks to the application under the Right to Information Act put up by Venkatesh Nayak. He is the program head of a division called the Access to Information of the non-government organization called the Commonwealth Human Rights Initiative. What the RBI has responded to Venkatesh Nayak's query after 28 months is very significant because it confirms the worst apprehensions that people had about the circumstances under which demonetization happened. Let's go step by step. Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced that about 86% of the currency in circulation would be illegal at 8 p.m. on the 8th of November 2016. The Reserve Bank of India convened a meeting of its board of directors at 5:30 p.m. that same evening. That is just 2.5 hours earlier.
Before the final announcement was made by the PM, the Reserve Bank board would have heard it for the first time that this was a proposal on the anvil.
We have for you in today's episode of Daily Roundup. To keep yourself updated in this coming elections, do log on to our website www.newsclick.in. Also, you can follow us on Facebook and YouTube.